Right, we'll start in another minute. Just give me some time. I'm trying to get the connections for. Yeah. Sorry. Right. Just give me a minute. Normal latency. Okay, I have again forgotten to put that at low latency, so there will be a lot of lag between where you put in questions and where I get the I have to reply. So please bear with me. So what I'll do is what happened was I was doing this 21 days of this one, but there was a lot of lag which was there in terms of internet issues. So what I have decided is that 21 days videos, I'll put in the 5 questions every day, definitely. But I'll put in a video format so you can look it at your comfort level and go about it. So that will help you with regards to preparation. So the basic idea today now out here will be to discuss about the preparation strategy and to answer any queries that you want. So today's questions I've already put on a YouTube channel. You can look at it and try to solve it. But before you solve the explanatory answer, please do look at the solve your questions on your own and then look at the explanatory answer. Hi Abul. Right, so we first have a general presentation on preparation strategy. In the meantime, you can put in any queries that you want and I will try to answer the queries. Okay, that's what I will do. So if you have any queries, please put up the query and then I'll answer the query as such. Okay, now what you need to do. The important aspect about preparation strategy is plan. So we are discussing a little bit on preparation strategy, and the most important aspect when you're looking at preparation strategy is the plans that you make. So if your plans are good, your preparation strategy will automatically be good. So ensure that you have a proper plans in place when you're preparing. Normally I would recommend that to have 3 plans as of now, and today when I'm talking about it, I would recommend 3 plans as such. Okay, one is the long-term plan, second is a plan till lockdown, and third is a daily plan. Okay, I'll be answering the queries also as and when we go. Someone is asking me, how is UBS Chandigarh, Sudarshan? It was once upon a time a good college. I think it's come down a bit in terms of ranking, but I think still it is a decent college to apply to and get admission. So I don't see a problem in UBS Chandigarh. But just talk to the students and figure out how the placements have been of late. But yes, once upon a time it was supposed to be a good college to apply to. Right? Kartik, the daily schedule for 8 months is a long schedule. I recommend to make a shorter schedule first before you make a longer schedule as such. That should help you better than making a longer schedule. So that's what I'm here looking at, making maybe a schedule in 3 stages as of now, right? And then working on it. Yes, if you have got a 33 percentile, you can definitely improve. I mean, I had a student who had some 41 or 42 percentile, went up to 99 percentile. So I'm sure with 33 percentile, I think you can definitely improve 90 plus, provided you have a right strategy in right place. Okay, Sudarshan, not sure about a cutoff of UBS right now, but it could be around 70-75 percentile as far as I know. If I'm Bangalore, I'm not very sure. I think it should be decent college where you can go about it. MICA is extremely good for marketing. It's worth taking up MICA as a college. If you're looking at MICA, it's a good college to take up. Atif, I normally recommend not to leave any topics for LRDI or CON because we don't know from which topic the easy sets will come into picture. So it makes sense to at least be comfortable with the basics of every topic. You need not go into a very high level as such, but at least the basics of every topic could be looked at. I think that is 11 lakhs per annum for UBS looks high, but check it out. I'm not sure. It's a government college, so it should not be too way off, but just check it out. So Russian, that should help. Good in my quant. Okay. Trimal. How can you good in a quant? Normally, I recommend in terms of quant preparation. Okay, what you need to do is spend 2 minutes per question before you actually start solving it. 10 2 minute per question without pen and just try to understand the question. That's all you do for 2 minutes. Just try to understand what the question is trying to say. Lot of problem that comes in the examinations, people don't understand what a problem is said and therefore they are not able to solve. So if you can spend 2 minutes for every question without pen trying to solve a con question, that should help you to improve with regards to Ajinkya. Maybe I'll have a separate thing for the cutoffs for the IIMs for SE category, but definitely is lower than the normal cutoff, so much lower, so 90 maybe percentile, and depends on your academics and lot of other factors. How can I prepare, Darshan? How can I prepare by going to a college like Indra for CAT again? I mean, there are people who go to college and prepare again, so I don't see a problem. I'm assuming that you already prepared once for the examination, so you can always prepare again. But normally, first year is very hectic, so you'll have to sort of balance off, focus more on mocks and analysis than maybe your basic preparation, right? Basics of quant, Weibo can pick up RS Agarwal, verbal and non-verbal reasoning. That's a good source for basics of quant. If you look at that, that will help you for basics for quant preparation. Okay, I think I'm getting a lot of queries today. I'll be coming in every day for answering your queries. So maybe today I'll take a few queries, tomorrow I'll take a few queries. So please bear with me with regards to this one. If I've answered your query about how to increase, better improve your quant, 2 minutes before every question, just think about a question that should help you. Honey, if you're weak in verbal, focus on reading. The more you read, the better it'll be. Moderate in DI, again, practice DLR. Quant, take a few questions only and try to look at alternate methods for solving, but focus more on reading and doing DLR. Okay, that's what you should focus on. And maybe cons, just maybe during the mocks will be fine. Maybe few questions, 3-4 questions every day, cons, maybe 5 questions, what we are doing out here. And looking at alternate methods should be enough for con preparation. Focus on verbal and DLR. Right? 2-year gap without any work experience, not advisable, pile. It makes sense to take up a job or start your own business. But that is better than maybe being at home. 1-year gap should be okay, but a 2-year gap is too high. I would not recommend a 2-year gap, doesn't make sense. Okay, Abhinav, you already started writing a mock, analyze your mock, that's very important. So that's the key in any particular mock, is you have to always pick up the easy questions and leave the difficult questions. The fact that you left the easy question basically means that you need to go back and check out how can you identify easy questions. That's very important as far as the examination is concerned. Try doing that. Got a 92.22 percentile in GAT is a very good percentile. Crack better colleges, then definitely wait. If you're just passed out recently and you feel you can wait, then you can definitely wait. Okay, so motivation, yes, I'm sure you can crack the examination. Just focus on changing your methods and don't be complacent because you scored 92 last year. That's very wrong. Keep on trying to improve and that's what should help you better, Devi Datta. Right? 4+ years experience. There are people, if you get into good college, Gaurav, no problem with 4 years experience. But with 4+ years work experience, I would recommend you to focus on GMAT than maybe purely CAT. So look at both, right? GMAT, right? CAT. Look at where you get better college and then take it up. So if I was you to plan, I would look at writing GMAT somewhere in July month and then to write a CAT in somewhere in the month of October, November. That's what you can do. I have people who have written GMAT in the month of October, September, October, and written CAT in November, got in IIM Lucknow. That is also have. At the age of 30, good decisions, Sibasis, I think you should focus on GMAT as well, apart from CAT. Write CAT, no harm in writing CAT. If you get a good college, take it up, but do write GMAT as well. Look at, keep your options open. That's very important in any scenario as such. Sir, can I score good in MBA CET without preparing for CAT? Yes, Srimal, there are a lot of people who do prepare for, without preparing for CAT, do score well in CET. There's no harm in that. You can do that as such. Telegram channel for CAT preparation. I will put the link in this one. After this particular session is over, I'll try to put this one. I have no idea about Adda 24/7 for con preparation, so very difficult to recommend you on that as such. What are the prices of your mocks? It's 1900 is the price of a mock for 10 mocks, but I will also be having maybe regular video session that will be guiding students regarding preparation in that. I'm reading novels and newspapers, but many times I'm unable to comprehend and gather the info about after reading. try, Pranay, to write a small summary after reading. Over a period of time, you will be able to gather the central idea of it. Maybe right now you can focus on writing the central idea of whatever you read. That should help you better as such. I have also a gap of 12 new extracurricular activities. So if you don't have extracurricular activities, look at options. There are also colleges that take up people without any, you know, great profile. So look at that option. I'll take up further queries tomorrow. Yeah, thanks. I'll try to create videos which will further motivate you all. For right now, let me focus on the plans. You should have three basic plans. One is a long-term plan. One is a plan up to 15 April and your daily plan. So just to brief you about it. For example, a long-term plan could be, I want to complete my syllabus, okay, by, let's say, June end. If I want to complete my syllabus by June end, so I'll break it up. So maybe April 15, I have a lot of time till April 15, I'll complete one third of the syllabus. From April 15 to May 15th, I'll complete one third of the syllabus. From May 15 to June 15, I will complete one third of the syllabus. Broad planning, to one third and one third. This is my long term plan, what is going to be, because I want to kind of complete the syllabus by June 15, let's say. I'll keep a little buffer in the end for that. If I want to complete my one third plan till 15 April, I look at how many chapters are there. Say in mathematics, I have total number of chapters as say 21. So one third is 7 chapters. So I should complete 7 chapters by 15th of June. So 15th of April, sorry. So that means if I want to complete 7 chapters by 15th of April, that means one chapter, 2 days. So that means I will try to complete one chapter every 2 days. So I will then plan accordingly. First day, what will I do? And second day, what will I do? That will basically help me to plan my overall schedule with regards to planning. And then I do a daily plan. Ideally, your daily plan should not only involve what you plan to do, but also when. So keep a time. Say morning 9 a.m. I will do reading. Say 10 a.m. I'll solve some questions of mathematics. So make a timetable of schedule with enough gaps in between to refresh yourself. Understand that. So if you can do this, I think your planning should be successful. This is a basic idea of plan which is there, right? I will try to, if you can do this, I'm sure it will help you with regards to your preparation. Okay, I'll answer a few more queries before I wind up. Aman Shukla, word power made easy. I mean, what I've heard a better book would have been like a GRE word list. If you're looking at SNAP, NMAT, etc., then GRE word list is a good option for looking at word list instead of maybe Word Power Made Easy. Word Power Made Easy also is good. So you can either look at Word Power Made Easy or GRE word list. Anything will do. Okay. Then 6 months sufficient for CAT? Yes, more than sufficient, Aditi. There are people with 6 to 8, even 3 to 4 months are prepared for CAT. So that is possible. So 6 months is enough time to prepare for CAT. I'm sure you'll be able to do it as long as you're regular with your preparation. How do we study CAT and CET in one preparation? Sanket, I would recommend you to focus on CAT till November and then look at CET. That's how you prepare for CAT and CET together. So focus on CAT and then on CET. Welcome, Trimal. Glad to help. Residential program for 1 week. I'm not sure. We'll try to have it, but can't comment on it right now, Vivek. We'll decide maybe later on. Easy enough. Can't comment about easiness, Aman. Good enough, maybe you can focus on Word Power Made Easy. Work X versus percentile, which matters more? Percentile, definitely. If you don't have percentile, then, but Work X, if you have, no harm. But there are also freshers who get into top colleges. So I had a student 2 years back who was just a BFM graduate who went to IIM Ahmedabad without any Work X. So there are a lot of people with freshers also getting into top college. So I don't see a problem freshers getting into college. Con from the very beginning, first you Dimulji, first you find out whether you're good or bad at quant. If you feel you're good at quant, you can directly jump to the CAT notes and try to solve. If you feel your quant is weak, then you can pick up books like R.S. Agarwal or your school max book and try to prepare on that. That should help you better. Arithmetics, Geo, I think I put questions separately today video. You can look at that and try to solve. Study plan for CAT repeaters. Sushant, I have made a video for CAT repeaters. You can go to my YouTube channel, you will get the video as such. If not, I'll try to make a video and then put it across as far as possible for you. Fine, I will already score 95% in CAT. How to prepare for CAT 20 Hitendra? Okay, Hitendra, yeah. So you are my student. You can always contact me whenever you want, Hitendra. So you call me and then maybe we can discuss about how to go about preparing. And then we can discuss about what to do. Study plan for CAT repeaters, I've already put it across. Okay. Sir, does online coaching really clarify the doubts? Depends from coaching institute to coaching institute. We have a policy of having an email and a WhatsApp group to solve your doubts. So everyone will have their own mechanism to solve doubts, which is there. So yes, I think online, there are some mechanisms to solve doubts if you're comfortable. But normally online is preferable for people who are self-motivated. So if you're motivated to prepare well, then I think online should help you. Right? Not sure. Online medium is where they teach you online, where you can discuss with them on a on an online platform, and they solve doubts separately as such. That should help. Okay, I will solve further queries tomorrow. I have a further class. You can see that I have a class now at 9:30. So I will be going for my class. I will definitely this one. Vivek, if you want to join my class, do contact me on my number or on the number. And tomorrow I have a demo session for my online class. You can sit for the demo session and then you can decide on that respect. So maybe if you can give me your email ID out here, I'll be able to send you the link for tomorrow's online class, demo class for the online this one, right? Fine. Internship normally doesn't count as WorkX. Perfect. I have to leave because of my class. So we'll see you next time tomorrow at 9 o'clock for sure to solve your doubts. Thanks for being there. Glad to help you all with regards to any doubts that you'll have. Right? Bye and see you all.